Hello my friends, welcome to my Energy Economist channel. We're gonna talk today about the existing research on gas hydrates, so stay with me. The research on gas hydrates can be categorized based on the research subjects of the efforts and application types. In terms of the types of research subjects, the categories include 1. Basic research, which focuses on the physical properties, phase, equilibrium, and kinetics of gas hydrates, and so on. 2. Geologic explorations of natural gas hydrate resources, which focus on the geological setting, bottom simulating reflectors, geochemical anomalies around the gas hydrate reservoirs, and so on. 3. Simulation techniques for the formation and dissociation processes, which include analytical, numerical, and experimental methods. 4. Hydrate-based new technologies, which as thermal energy storage, separation of gas mixtures, storage of natural gas. Alternatively, previous studies on gas hydrates can be grouped based on their application types, where the advances in this topic can be followed in chronological order, i.e. 1. Flow assurance, 2. Energy recovery, 3. Hydrate-based new technologies, gas storage, transportation, and 4. Environmental applications, safety, and climate change. Interest in gas hydrates was firstly sparked in the early 19th century by chemists when making hydrates of different gases, mostly as a curiosity in the laboratory. In 1810, Sir Humphry Davy observed that a solid could be formed when an aqueous solution of chlorine was cooled in a temperature below 9 Celsius. Faraday confirmed the existence of this solid compound, the composition of which was believed to be 1 part of chlorine and 10 parts of water. It's now recognized that more than 100 species of gases can be combined with water to form non-stoichiometric solid compounds, to which the term gas hydrates has been applied. During the first 100 years after the discovery of gas hydrates, most interest in these compounds was pure academic, and the primary efforts were to understand 1. What species can form hydrates, and 2. What are the thermodynamic conditions for the gas hydrates formation. Industrial interest in gas hydrates began in the 1930s, accompanying the booming of gas and oil industry due to the discovery that hydrate formation could plug natural gas pipelines. In 1934, Hammerschmidt noted that blockage observed in some gas transmission pipelines was gas hydrates rather than ice. Thereafter, much research, including extensive thermodynamic studies, was carried out to understand the conditions of hydrate formation. The natural gas industry considered methane hydrates only as a nuisance, which occasionally plugs up pipelines or causes wellbores to collapse. However, this promoted intense research efforts on natural gas hydrates by industry, government, and academia. More information about these research efforts can be found in the monograph of Dayton and Frost. The third period in the history of gas hydrate studies was initiated by the discovery of naturally occurring gas hydrates under different geological formations. In the 1960s, it was realized that clathrate hydrates of natural gas exists in vast quantities in the Earth's crust. For example, gas production from naturally occurring hydrate deposits was reported in the Musiaka field in western Siberia, where an interval saturated with gas hydrates overlaid a gas saturated formation. The discovery of naturally occurring gas hydrates coincided with the peak of a global energy crisis, which pushed forward the study of gas hydrates in the 1970s. Starting in the 1970s, the search for oil and gas extended into regions which were more difficult to explore, but where geological temperatures and pressures were suitable for the formation of natural gas hydrates. Natural gas hydrates, once considered merely as nuisance in gas pipelines, were then examined as a long-term energy resource. A bottom simulating reflector was commonly employed to mark the base of gas hydrates in marine sediments. The large amounts of gas in hydrate form justified efforts to find economic recovery schemes. The need to understand gas hydrates together with other technological considerations motivated most of these research efforts, along with the investigations in gas hydrates as an energy resource. More concern regarding the influence of gas hydrates recovery of naturally dissociation on the climate change ecosystems and stability of gas hydrate reservoirs, including wellbore safety, has been expressed. For example, studies on the process of formation and dissociation of gas hydrates in many recent studies are focused on the problems of hydrate formation in the phase zones of boreholes, inside boreholes, and in pipelines. Despite the concern with the potential detrimental effects, there have also been efforts in developing innovative technologies based on the characteristics of gas hydrates for various purposes, such as natural gas storage, hydrogen storage, thermal energy storage, and separation of gas mixtures. By reviewing the research on gas hydrates, the state of the art and the key challenges for the future advances in gas hydrates research can be summarized as follows. 1. In flow assurance research, a new approach known as risk management is being developed to take the place of conventional methods such as thermodynamic chemical inhibitor injection due to economic and ecological concerns. 2. Various aspects for gas recovery from hydrate bearing formation are being investigated for commercial recovery due to the huge potentials. 3. The environmental impact of naturally occurring hydrates is still mostly unknown, but has been arousing increasing interest. 4. The use of hydrates to store fuel is an existing prospect that has potential advantages over other storage materials. It should be noted that recovering gas hydrates from naturally occurring reservoirs reserves as the major stimulus for various research on gas hydrates, and substantial computer simulations and laboratory experiments have been conducted while in situ explorations have just started. However, the behaviors of gas hydrate in porous media have not been completely understood. Permafrost hydrates are being considered for production tests in the USA, while efforts for marine gas hydrate are also being explored due to the huge amount of marine hydrates by several orders of magnitude larger than that in the permafrost areas. If you want to learn more about the existing research on gas hydrates, you could do so in my book, Economic Study of Oil and Gas Exploration, which is published on Amazon. Check it out at the link in the description. Please take a second to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and don't forget to also hit the notification bell. Thank you for watching and goodbye.